as I was a-travelling in the North Country. Down by Kirby Stephen I happened for to be. As I was a-walking up and down the street, a pretty little by a broom I chanced for to meet. And she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish young by a broom that led me astray. She kindly then invited me to go along the way. Yes was the answer to her that I did say. There was me with me music walking down the street, and her with a tambourine was beating hand and feet. For she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish hung by a broom that led me astray. Straightway for Kendal we steered her and I. Over yon white mountain the weather it was dry. We each had a bottle filled up to the top, and whenever we were feeling dry we took a little drop. For she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish hung by a broom that led me astray. The night coming on, good lodgings we did find, eatables of all sorts and plenty of good wine. Good bed and blankets just for we two, and I rolled her in me arms, me boys, and wouldn't you do too? For she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish hung by a broom that led me astray. Well, early the next morning we arose to go our way. I called to the landlord to see what was to pay. 14 and 6 pence just for you two, and a fiver on the table, oh me darling, then she threw. For she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish hung by a broom that led me astray. Now the reason that we parted I now will let you hear. She started off for Germany right early the next year, and me not being willing to cross the raging sea is a help to me by a broom wherever she may be. For she was right, I was tight, everybody has their way. It was the lish hung by a broom that led me astray.
Adieu, sweet, lovely Nancy, 10,000 times adieu. I'm a-going around the ocean, love to seek for something new. Come change your ring with me, dear girl, come change your ring with me. For it might be a token of true love while I am on the sea. And when I'm far upon the sea, you know not where I am. Kind letters I will write to you from every foreign land. The secrets of your heart, dear girl, are the best of my goodwill. So let your body be where it might, my heart will be with you still. There's a heavy storm arising, see how it gathers round. While we poor souls on the ocean wide are fighting for the crown. There's nothing to protect us, love, or keep us from the cold. On the ocean wide where we must bide like jolly seamen bold. There's tinkers, tailors, shoemakers lie snoring fast asleep. While we poor souls on the ocean wide are ploughing through the deep.
Our officers commanded us,
and then we must obey. expecting every moment for to get cast away. But when the wars are over, there'll be peace on every shore. We'll return to our wives and our families and the girls that we adore.
We'll call for liquor merrily
and spend our money free. And when our money is all gone, we'll boldly go to sea.
I'm a maid that's deep in love, but yes, I can complain. I have in this world but one true love, and Jimmy is his name. And if I do not find my love, I'll mourn most constantly. And I'll find and follow Jimmy to the lands of liberty. Then I'll cut off my yellow locks, men's clothing I'll wear on. I'll assign to a bold sea captain my passage I'll work free. And I'll find and follow Jimmy to the lands of liberty. One night along the raging seas, as we were going to bed, the captain cried, "Farewell, my boy, I wish you were a maid. Your rosy cheeks and ruby lips, they are enticing me. And I wish to God with all my heart a maid you were to me." "Then hold your tongue, dear captain, such talk is all in vain. And if the sailors find it out, they'd laugh and make much game. For when we reach Columbia's shore, some prettier girls you'll find. And you'll laugh and sing and court with them, for courting you are inclined." Well, it was not 3 days after our ship it reached the shore, but adieu, my loving captain, adieu forevermore. For once I was a sailor on sea, but now I'm a maid on the shore. So bid adieu to you and all your crew, for with you I'll sail no more. Come back, my own pretty maid, come back and marry me. I have £3,000 in gold, and that I'll give to thee. So come back, my own pretty maid, come back and marry me.
I am a sailor, brisk and bold, that oft have sailed the ocean. I've travelled the country far and near for honour and promotion. Me shipmates all, I bid you adieu, I may no longer go along with you. I'll travel the country through, and they'll call me the rambling sailor. And if you want to know my name it is Young Johnson. I've got a commission from the king to court all girls is handsome. With my false heart and flattering tongue, I'll court them all, both old and young. I'll court them all, but I marry none, and they call me the rambling sailor. Well, first I come to Plymouth town, and there were lasses many. I boldly stepped unto a one to court her for a money. Says I, me dear, be of good cheer, I will not leave you, do not fear. I'll travel the country far and near, and they call me the rambling sailor. And next I come to Portsmouth town, and there was lasses plenty. I boldly stepped unto a one to court her for a beauty. Says I, me dear, what do you choose? Here's ale and a wine and a rum punch too, besides a pair of silk satin shoes, if you travel with a rambling sailor. And then I rose up with the dawn, just as the day was peeping. On tiptoe down the stairs I went, and I left my love sleeping. And if she waits until I come, she may lie there till the day of her doom. I'll court some other girl in her room, and they'll call me the rambling sailor.
In Bruton town there lived a farmer who had two sons and one daughter dear. By day and night they were conspiring to fill their parents' heart with fear. He told his secret to no other, but to her brother this he said: I think a servant courts a sister, I think they have a mind to wed. I'll put an end to all their courtship, I'll send him silent to his grave. They asked him then to go a-hunting without any fear or strife, but these two bold and wicked villains, they took away this young man's life. And in the ditch there was no water, where only bush and briars grew. They could not hide the blood of slaughter, so in the ditch his body threw. When they returned home from hunting, she asked them for her servant man. I ask because I see you whisper, so brothers tell me if you can. Sister, sister, you do offend me, that you so examine me. We've lost him when we've been a-hunting, no more of him we could not see. As she lay dreaming on her pillow, She thought she saw her heart's delight by her bedside as she lay weeping. He was all dressed in his bloody coat. Don't weep for me, my dearest jewel. Don't weep for me, or care or pine. For your two brothers killed me cruel. In such a place you made me find. So she rose early the next morning with a heavy sigh and bitter groan. The only love that she admired she found in a ditch where he was thrown. 3 days and night she did sit by him till her poor heart was filled with woe. Then cruel hunger came upon her and to a home she had to go. When she returned to her brothers, sister, what makes you look so thin? Brother, don't ask the reason of me, or for his sake you shall be hung.
Farewell, my lovely Nancy, for I must now leave you. Unto the salt seas I am bound for to go. But let my long absence be no trouble to you, for I will return in the spring, as you know. Like some pretty little sea boy, I will dress and go with you. In the deepest of dangers, I shall stand your friend. In the cold, stormy weather, when the winds they are a-blowing, my love, I'll be willing to wait on you then. Your pretty little hands cannot handle our tackle. Your pretty little feet to our topmast can't go. And the cold, stormy weather, love, you never could endure. Therefore, lovely Nancy, to the sea do not go. Farewell, my lovely Nancy, for I must now leave you. Unto the salt seas I am bound for to go. But let my long absence be no trouble to you, for I will return in the spring, as you know. It's hard when folks can't find their work where they've been bred and born. When I was young, I always thought I'd bide midst roots and corn. But I've been forced to work in town, so here's my litany. From Hull and Halifax and Hell, good Lord, deliver me. When I was caught in Mary Jane, the old squire, he says to me, I've got no rooms for wedded folk. Choose whether to go or to stay. I could not give up the girl I love, so to town I was forced to flee. From Hull and Halifax and hell, good Lord deliver me. I've worked in Leeds and Huddersfield, and I've earned some honest brass. In Bradford, Keighley, Rotherham, I've kept me bairns and lass. I've travelled all three ridings round, and once I went to sea. From forges, mills and coal and boats, good Lord deliver me. I've walked at night through Sheffield loins, 'twas just like being in hell. Where furnaces thrust out tongues of fire and roared like the wind on the fell. I've sammed up coals in Barnsley pit with muck up to my knee. From Barnsley, Sheffield, Rotherham, good Lord deliver. I've seen fog creep across Leeds Bridge as thick as the Bastille Sioux. I've lived where folks were stowed away like rabbits in a coop. I've seen snow float down Bradford Beck as black as ebony. From Hunslet, Holbeck, Whibsy, Stack, good Lord deliver me. But now that all our children have gone to the country, we've come back. There's 40 miles of heathery moor twixt us and the Coalpit Stack. And as I sit by the fire at night, I'll laugh and shout with glee. From Hull and Halifax and hell, the good Lord deliver.
It's of a brisk young butcher, as I have heard them say. He started out of London town all on a certain day. Says he, a frolic I will have my fortune for to try. I will go into Leicestershire some cattle for to buy. When he arrived at Leicester town, he came into an inn. He called for an ostler, and boldly he walked in. He called for liquors of the best he'd been a robin blade, and quickly fixed his eyes upon the lovely chambermaid. When she took up a candle to light him up to bed, and when she came into the room, these words to her he said: "One sovereign I will give to you all to enjoy your charms." And this fair maid all night did sleep all in the butcher's arms. 'Twas early the next morning he prepared to go away. The landlord said, "Your reckoning, sir, you have forgot to pay." "Oh no," the butcher did reply, "pray do not think it strange. One sovereign I gave your maid, and I haven't got the change." They straightway called the chambermaid and charged her with the same. The golden sovereign she laid down for fear she'd get the blame. The butcher, he then went home well pleased with what was past. But soon this pretty chambermaid grew thick about the waist. 'Twas in a twelvemonth after he came to town again, and then as he had done before he stopped at that same inn. 'Twas then the buxom chambermaid she chanced him for to see. She bought a babe just 3 months old and placed him on his knee. The butcher sat like one amazed, and at the child did stare. But when the joke he did find out, how he did stamp and swear. She said, "Kind sir, it is your own, pray do not think it strange. One sovereign you gave to me, and here I've brought your change. So come all you brisk and lively blades, I pray be ruled by me. Look well into your bargains before your money pay, or soon perhaps your folly will give you cause to range. If ever you sport with pretty maids, you're sure to get your change."
Old Martin said to his man, "Fie, man, fie." Martin said to his man, "Who's a fool now?" Old Martin said to his man, "Fill the cup and I the can. Thou wast well drunken, man, who's a fool now?" I saw the man in the moon,
"Fie, man, fie."
I saw the man in the moon,
who's a fool now?
I saw the man in the moon, clouds in off St. Peter's shoe.
Thou wast well drunken, man,
who's a fool now? I saw a hare chase a hound,
"Fie, man, fie."
I saw a hare chase a hound,
who's a fool now?
I saw a hare chase a hound 20 miles above the ground.
Thou wast well drunken, man,
who's a fool now? I saw a mouse chase a cat,
"Fie, man, fie."
I saw a mouse chase a cat,
who's a fool now?
I saw a mouse chase a cat, saw a cheese eat a rat.
Thou wast well drunken, man,
who's a fool now? Martin said to his man,
"Fie, man, fie."
Martin said to his man,
"Who's a fool now?"
Oh, Martin said to his man, "Fill the cup and I the can.
Thou wast well drunken, man,
who's a fool now?"
A wager I will lay. I will lay you 500 to 1 that you don't follow me unto yonder blooming tree, or a maiden you never shall return. So they both jogged along unto yonder blooming tree, the weather being very mild and warm. And he became quite weary, he sat down for to rest. Then he fell fast asleep upon the grass. she walked the place all around, and nine times she walked it all around, and nine times she kissed his red and rosy cheeks as he lay fast asleep upon the ground. Then a ring from her finger she earnestly drew, and placed it on her true love's right hand, saying, "This shall be a token for my true love when he wakes. He will find that I have been, but now I'm gone. If I had been awake, love, when I was fast asleep, of you I would have had my will. Or you I would have killed, and your blood I would have spilled, and the small birds should all have had their fill. Be cheerful, and do not repine, for now 'tis as clear as the sun. The money, the money, the money, it is mine, the wager I fairly have won. The money, the money, the money, it is mine, the wager I fairly have won."
Oh, don't you remember a long time ago, those two little babies, their names I don't know. They strayed far away one bright summer's day. These two little babies got lost on their way. Pretty babes in the wood, pretty babes in the wood. Oh, don't you remember those babes in the wood? Now the day being long, and the night coming on, these two little babies sat under a stone. They sobbed and they sighed, they sat down and cried. These two little babies, they lay down and died. Pretty babes in the wood, pretty babes in the wood. Oh, don't you remember those babes in the wood? Now the robin so red, so swiftly they sped. They put out their wide wings and over them spread. And all the day long the branches did throng. They sweetly did carol, and this was their song. Pretty babes in the wood, pretty babes in the wood. Oh, don't you remember those babes in the wood?
Adam and Eve could never believe that Peter the Miller was dead. Shut up in a tower for stealing a flower, and never could get a reprieve. And never could get a reprieve. They bored a hole in Oliver's nose and put therein a string, and drew him around about the town for murdering Charles our King. For murdering Charles our King. Adam and Eve could never believe that Peter the Miller was dead. Shut up in a tower for stealing a flower, and never could get a reprieve. And never could get a reprieve.